Hello everyone, welcome to SQL Depository. I am Saras Pandey and you are watching module 7.3 of Postgres administration. In this module, we will talk about another config file of Postgres, which is pg_hba.conf. So HBA stands for host based authentication. So this config file talks about the authentications. So let me go ahead and edit this file. So for this, I will write nano and then the location of the config file, which is etc postgresql 15 main pg_hba.conf. Hit enter and this file is open. Let me scroll down. And then I want you to look at this first entry here, which is for local database all user Postgres and method is peer. So peer method is all about using the same user as the OS user. So if the OS user is Postgres, then you can connect using Postgres user to your Postgres instance, Postgres SQL instance. But if you are connected to your virtual machine or to your server using any other user, then it will not allow you to connect Postgres instance using Postgres user. So let me actually close this and run psql. And here I am connected using Postgres instance. So if I'll hit psql, it will connect to Postgres using the Postgres user. So if I want to check the user, so for this I'll type connect info, hit enter, and it says you are connected to database Postgres as user Postgres via socket and the port number. So I'm connected using Postgres user. But what if I'm not connected using Postgres user to my virtual machine? So for this I'll quit. Then I'll try to switch the user from Postgres to Ubuntu, hit enter, give the password for Ubuntu user, and then try connecting psql using Postgres user. And it is saying that peer authentication failed for user Postgres, and rightly so, because I am not connected to virtual machine using Postgres user. So peer authentication should not work in that case. But let me switch back to Postgres. And edit the config file again. Scroll down here. If I'll change the authentication from peer to trust, so I'll go to the method, change it to trust, save the file, then I will load the pgctl again. So pgctl is another utility that Postgres provide, and if you'll type pg_ctl, then reload, it should reload the configs. But in your case, there is a possibility that you will get the error for pgctl if pgctl bin directory is not added to the environment variables. So it will not be able to find pg_ctl file. So for this, what you have to do is you have to type nano editor, then the bash rc profile you need to edit, hit enter, and here go to variant, and once you will reach at the end, you have to type path is equals to $path colon, and then give the path of your bin directory, which is user usr lib postgresql 15 bin in my case. If you have installed with me the Postgres instance, then in your case also it should be the same path, because you must have installed the same version. But if you have installed any other version, then you will have to provide the appropriate path. Let me save this file and then run source bash rc file and then you are done. Now if you'll run pgctl, it will identify the file because it has the location of the bin directory. But I'm still expecting an error. If I hit enter, it says no database directory because I have not defined the pg data variable, which I will define in the next video. But for this video, to remove this error, what I'll do, I'll give the data directory path, which is where lib PostgreSQL 15 main, and hit enter, and it says server signaled, which means my command worked and the, you know, the configuration has been reloaded. So if I'll type PSQL again, Postgres user is connecting and it was connecting in case of peer authentication also. So this is fine. Let me quit from here and then switch user to Ubuntu. Hit enter, give the password for Ubuntu. And here if I'll type connecting Postgres instance using Postgres user, it is also able to connect. But it did not ask for any password even from the Ubuntu user because this authentication does not require any password. So that is why it is fine locally. But if you are giving authentication from outside this virtual machine or outside the server, never use trust authentication. It is not safe. So let me quit from here. Switch back to Postgres user. Oops, I forgot the space, the password. Now I'm connected using Postgres user. So let me edit the file again. And this time I will use another authentication, which is MD5. Okay, so let me actually cancel this and connect to Postgres instance because I have not set any password for my Postgres user in the PostgreSQL instance. So MD5 is the password authentication method. And until I'll not set the password for this user, I cannot use MD5 authentication for this user. So for this, let me write alter user Postgres password and then give a password for this user. So in my case, I'm just giving a very simple password, which is QWERTY. It is not a good password, but I'm doing it just for the sake of this video. And after that, in my case, even the public IP will change and I will also change the password for this user. So this is okay. But if you are doing it in your production environment, give a strong password there. Okay, let me quit from here and then edit the config file again and change the authentication method to MD5. So here I will remove trust and give the authentication method to MD5. Save the file and then run PSQL again, and it is connected. Because every time you will make any change in the config file, you need to reload the configs. So let me quit from here and then run the same command again, which is for pg_ctl. Okay, so it is giving the complete path. This is not required here because I've already defined the the bin directory path in my environment variables. So I don't have to provide the complete path, but the data directory path is still required because I have not defined the pg data variable yet. So the config file is reloaded. Now, if I'll run PSQL again, this time it is asking for the password, right? So this is the password for Postgres user because I have not given any username. So it will automatically connect to the same user using which I'm connected to the virtual machine. Give the password, hit enter, and it says password authentication failed for user Postgres, which is quite weird because I should not get it. Maybe I have done some mistake while providing the password. Oh, I have just reset the password and I forgot completely. So let me give the new password. Hit enter and I'm connected. So QWERTY is my new password and I was still giving the old password. So that is why it was keep on throwing the error. But when I've given the correct password, I'm connected. But this time I'm connected using the password. Quit from here, switch the user to Ubuntu. Now, if I'll use psql and the username Postgres, hit enter, it is asking for the password for Ubuntu user also. So let me give the password, hit enter, and I'm connected using Postgres user. So if you want to check, you can always run connect info and you can verify the database, the user and the socket file and also the port. Let me quit from here. So now you have learned about peer authentication, trust authentication and MD5 authentication. So this is what I wanted to cover in this video, but there is still something that is pending related to HBA file, and that is, what if I want to access the Postgres instance directly from any other host, not locally? So whatever we did in this video, we were connecting to Postgres instance locally, which means I was already connected to the virtual machine. But what if I don't want to connect to the virtual machine, but directly to the Postgres instance from my laptop, desktop, or from any other server or any other machine? Then how exactly we can use HBA file to authenticate this? That we will cover in our next video. Thank you for watching this video.